Hey y'all, I wanted to play a song for you today, a song that is of particular significance in my life. It was the first song that I ever sang in front of a group of people, like not my mom, and I realized that I was a singer. I was 9 years old and I was in the third grade, and I was staying at my friend Sherry Northcutt's house in the summertime. While my parents were working. And so she had a bunch of brothers. She was a really sweet girl. She was really cute, long red hair. She was beautiful. She had a bunch of brothers, and we used to play with the boy next door who was a little bit older than us. And we used to play matchbox cars and cowboys and Indians and stuff like that. And we also used to play a little game called Miss America. And since there were a lot of boys that we used to play with, there were never very many girls, so the girls would be the contestants in Miss America, and the boys would sit them at the picnic table, and they would be the judges. So one of the guys would be the MC, and we would find pieces of paper or cardboard or whatever we could, and that would be their little placard that they would hold up with our score. So it was kind of like a cross between the Olympics and Miss America. So they would interview us, and then we would do the wave, and they would crown us, and we would have the bathing suit contest. And you know, every girl knows you take the bottom of your shirt and you tuck it in here and you pull it down and it makes a halter top. And so we would strut around, you know, and they would judge us. It was really degrading. And so we would also have talent. And in 1978, I was an accomplished disco dancer. So I used to do a lot of disco dancing for my talent. But this particular day, I decided I was going to sing something. So I chose a song that I knew by heart that I had learned from one of my mom's Barry Manilow records. And I sang it, and I got perfect tens from the judges. And I'm sure that that also made me more attractive in the bathing suit competition. And I actually ended up being crowned Miss America for the very first time because Sherry was really cute and she always won. And I think the boy next door kind of had a crush on her. So I had never won before, so that was a very significant fact in my life. And I remember standing there singing in front of everybody and having this revelation of, wow, I'm good at this. They're paying attention to me. This is fun. I wanted to share this song with you and see if you remember this old tune. You know I can't smile without you. I can't smile. I find it hard to do anything. You see, I feel sad when you're sad. I feel glad when you're glad. If you only knew what I'm going through, I just can't smile without you. Like a song and brighten my day. Who'd have believed that you were part of a dream? Now it all seems light years away. And now you know I can't smile without you. I can't smile without you. I can't laugh and I can't sing. I'm finding it. I feel sad when you're sad. I feel glad when you're glad. If you only knew what I'm going through, I just can't smile. Now some people say happiness takes so very long to find. Well, I'm finding it hard. Your love behind me. You have it. The very first song that I ever sang in front of people and made me who I am today. Too bad I didn't have my ukulele, would have dropped them dead at Miss America.